Hi everyone, and welcome to another daily video from Shopify Dropshipping Lifestyle. My name is Ricky Hayes, and in today's video, we're all going into how to make custom audiences and how to make lookalike audiences in Facebook Business Manager, okay? So let's get straight into it. So in relation to this, you're going to need a business manager. I've gone through this in previous videos, but I am making more specific videos. So if you have a business manager, again, just make one. Just literally Google, create Facebook business manager, will guide you through it. You make your business manager. You'll only be making custom audiences and lookalike audiences once you've started getting sales and traction anyway. So that's perfectly fine. But basically what you do is you jump into your ad account. It's very easy once you know. It's like anything really. Is you want to click your three horizontal lines here and you go audiences. Spend a bit of time in your audiences because it's you'll just end up spending a lot of time here. So I must have made, I've saved the audience. That was my bad. But anyway, it doesn't matter. So basically, if I want to create an audience, it won't let me actually, it will let me do this. So you can make it off various different things, okay? So this is the part you wanna hammer home. Customer file is if you have emails, okay? If you have shit tons of emails, even, 500 is enough. So you can upload these and you can use it for retargeting, or you can make a custom audience and then you can make a lookalike from it. So if you have 500 emails of people in the same sort of niche, then you can use that to make lookalikes. It's pretty cool. Website traffic is the one where you'll spend a lot of your time. So I don't have all the attributes here, but mainly you want to make lookalikes on all website visitors in the last 180 days. You want to make people who visited a specific page in the last 180 days. So your specific product, you want to make them off, you can make them off time spent. That's really when you start scaling, you make these. You make it off view content. So view content of a specific product. So when you are doing it, basically what you do, so let's say we choose this one of the specific product page, which is what most people do, and that's fine. So we put dog collar, doesn't matter, and you just go tab, and that what it's gonna do basically is because you've got your pixel connected to your store, it then uses the pixel, and this is the end URL. So it's going to find on your pixel, which is connected to your Shopify store, a URL that contains this. So you gotta make, this is why it's important to have your URLs unique. So if you choose the unique part of that URL, it'll then, this is basically just a filter. You can then refine it further. So you could go frequency, you could go include more. So you could include people that visited this webpage and another webpage. You could go people that visited this webpage, but exclude people that have previously purchased. That's all it is the custom audiences is basically just, you have your pixel of hundreds of thousands of fires of different things, and you're making a filter to say, I want this set of people. So rather than the 100,000, you get 1,000. And then from those 1,000 people, you can retarget them. You can all make, in most cases, lookalikes. So this is what I do. So I call it CA for custom audience. And in this case, I would call it dog collar, so that I can identify it. Then, now that I know that it's a custom audience and it's for my dog collar, I want to be more specific about what this custom audience is. Because I can make heaps of custom audiences of this dog collar. Having a good naming convention helps you filter and find this easier. So CA, custom audience, dog collar, or product, and then you want to put, so they know it's the dog collar, you want to put, in this case, 30 days. So, sorry, no. You want to put visited web page, just something like that, just to identify it. So basically just something visited specific web page. You could even put VC because it really is much the same thing. So visited web page, and then you put the days, so 30 days. Basically what you're doing is like the same as what I teach with actually making the ads, is you use the same convention of what it is. So it's a custom audience. What's the product? What type of objective is it? So is it visited web page, view content, add to cart? Visited web page and view content are pretty much the same thing. So I don't know, there's a few of these sort of gray zones, I'll be honest. And then you wanna put the dates. So you can tell the dates, because you might wanna make an intricate retargeting campaign. So you might make one day they get retargeted, then 7 days they get retargeted again, and then 14, then so on and so forth. And doing this helps you to identify, because when you're making the ad, you want to be able to know what the custom audience you've made is, because otherwise then you're not really trying to push what objective you're personally pushing for. So then you go create audience. This is going to come up red. Obviously, I have absolutely no data on this pixel, but you can see it's going to say it's populating. Give it 30 to 60 minutes to populate. It depends on your pixel, but 60 minutes is pretty much fine. And then what you want to do is you just highlight, and now you can make a lookalike. So you can now make a lookalike, okay? And so again, this is where you choose your countries that you want to choose. Your source being the custom audience. So see how it shows up? So straight away at face value, I know what this is. That's why it's important to have that naming convention. Then we want to choose location. So I'm just going to use for this one, United States. You can add as many as you want. See, it's really annoying that you can't add Europe. Really annoying. Because I target a lot of European countries. I just want to target Europe as a region, but now you have to target each one. Yeah, because I totally remember which fucking country is all the countries in Europe. Anyway, so then you put in the country, and then you choose your audience size. So it'll have audience size of 2.2 million. Now that's pretty much standard for any audience size that Facebook will make for you for these percentiles. Now, when I do it, is I change it. I actually do this in Trackify personally because it's better, but starting out, this is fine. So you can see how if I were to leave these open, how it just gets larger and larger and larger of an audience. Now, I only test, I test each percentage, basically, logically speaking. I don't know, there's a lot of people that actually test 1, 2, 3, and then 0 to 5, and then 6 to 10. You can test them. And I have had varied results, but I've found that, like, logically speaking, again, I like to make this logical because it makes sense to me, is that I just test each one individually, and that's why I test on low budget, so you're not wasting any money. So unfortunately, I don't know why they set the number of audiences as 6. If in Trackify, you can actually just do all 10 at once, and so it makes it really easy. Whereas opposed to this, you'd have to do it twice so that you can then include the other percentiles, which is kind of annoying, but that's just the way it is. So anyway, so if I were to do this, that's how I would do it. You then make it for every percentile, and you'll find a couple of these work and a couple don't. And if you want, you can go back, and then you can make one that's 0 to 5 and 6 to 10. Apparently, those convert quite well too. They're very large audiences. Obviously, it's got a lot of sort of overlap there. So, but not that that really matters. But that's pretty much it. Like, there really isn't that much to it. It's basically just making a custom audience. The custom audience is the hard part, because that's where you're basically doing your filter. So you have to make sure you do it properly. So, you know, if you're doing it for the dog collar, for visited webpage or view content, then you want to make sure it's set up properly. And that's when, once you know you've set that up properly, you can make your lookalikes, or then you can use that custom audience for retargeting, okay? For mainly, if you're doing a custom audience for the basis of lookalike, you want to do 180 days because you want to capture all that data. The more data you have in a custom audience, the better your lookalikes will be, okay, when you make them. So if you are making them, then it will work better for you, because that's why you choose 180 days. It doesn't let you do more, I believe. So just choose 180 days for a custom audience on the various thing, add to cart, whether it's add to cart, view content, purchase, add payment info, initiate checkout, so that you're capturing as much as possible. So that when you make a lookalike, you're getting, in theory, you're getting potentially the best lookalike audiences, because the more data Facebook have, the more targeted it is. If you are doing a custom audience for retargeting, that's where you obviously change that around. So you're probably doing it 1 day custom audience, 7, 3 day, 7, 14, 30. That's where you basically just duplicate the exact same thing, except the days is the difference. So that's why you wouldn't use those type of lookalike audiences, custom audiences to make lookalikes, because it's not for that type of objective, okay? So you got to understand the difference. If you're doing retargeting, then you set it up much the same except lower days. If it is for lookalikes, set it to 180 days so you get the best looking lookalikes that you can. All right. So the other thing to include is obviously the more countries you just add them in, these will get larger and larger. But you can see how you can make a heap of lookalikes. You know, you could make so many, you know, of various results. You know, you could make one that literally has 21 million people in if you really wanted. I haven't done it. You can, though. You can. And that's in... There is no one set path. I'm not going to lie. But that's why for me, my path that I've decided to take is I just do one. I do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I do all of them. And 2.5 million on $5 budgets, bumping them up slowly and etc. is going to be months. Months of and then you just make another one, you know, like off view content, add to cart, time visited web page, different products that you find are doing well. You can do so much and you just extend the shit out of it because there's millions of people. And that's why, like, you know, everyone says to have, this is why I take the approach of a larger audience to begin with, because everyone says once you make lookalikes anyway, your audiences are in the millions anyway. Facebook know how to optimize. It doesn't make any difference if it's at the start of the line or the end of the line. It just says, you want this objective, I'll give you this objective. And you keep your audience within this confines and you'll be fine. So I actually, this is what came up with my theory for my strategy is that Facebook have pretty much given us most of the answers. Just I follow that same strategy and it works well. There isn't a huge amount to it. So that's pretty much it from today's video. Pretty short and easy one, really. The group's growing. I'm absolutely loving it. Again, did my live, absolutely loved it. I'm gonna, as I said, post once a week about what videos you wanna see. And then from those, find 7 topics that I believe haven't been covered, then make a poll, and then you will all decide what ones in what order are made. And then I will do that accordingly. There is a link below for my Patreon. If you join my Patreon, you get access to my exclusive Discord channel. It is very new, so if you jump in there now, you are likely to have pretty much one-on-one conversation with me. I am far more responsive than I am in there than I would be in a personal message. I don't respond to those as much, and I am dwindling that down a bit more because I just get overwhelmed. Another point is I am doing my one-on-one coaching. You've probably seen I released a video last night. I made a few mistakes there and I'm fixing that. But I only do I don't want to do any more than like 7 or so a week. It's just, I have other things to do. So if you want to jump on that, there's a link below as well. I've also got an Instagram if you want to follow me on Instagram, which is something that I'm slowly working on. But my main one is obviously join my Facebook group, the Shopify Dropshipping Lifestyle. It's growing very quickly, okay? But I would appreciate, you know, if you do like my content and you do want to support me, the Patreon's the best way of doing it. I'm never going to make a course, I've decided. That's why I make the Patreon. It's your way of supporting me. Or if you're making a new store, there's the Shopify affiliate link down below if you want to use that. I'm just trying to be completely transparent with you guys. I was a bit hesitant about it, but I think a part of my charm is that I do want to be transparent, and I think that's just very important to me, so I'm not going to hide it. Further updates is I'm going to be doing a live once a week on Facebook, whether it's like store reviews and stuff, so I'll be putting out schedules for that for you all to join, so the more we can get interactive there, the more support I give you all, which is really cool. But if you did like today's video, please drop a like, hit the subscribe button, the notification bell, and drop a comment below. If you have any feedback, any questions, I had someone give me some feedback about one of my thumbnails, a typo in there. So thank you very much for that. I love when I get that feedback. It's very useful. Just going to keep growing the YouTube channel. I've got a lot in store for YouTube. I'm really trying to work really hard now on the back end with YouTube. To really, one, obviously I want more organic reach, but two, try and tailor it more to what you all need. And that's why I'm really trying to start with these getting your feedback for what you want, and then a poll, and then make a video around it, and improve YouTube just as a whole, so that the whole experience is congruent and for what you guys want and need, whether on Facebook and YouTube, and then there's Discord and that, and it's just going to keep growing. You know, unfortunately, I don't have all the time in the day, so it is a bit of a slow churn, but I am trying to take on as much feedback and give tangible outcomes that will all help you, okay? So thank you very much for watching today's video. I will talk to you all tomorrow. Have a lovely day and take care. Goodbye.